Hey guys, this is Chase Harrison, CEO of Alta Labs. The long-awaited moment is here. I am proud to be able to present Route 10, a powerful 10 gigabit per second hardware accelerated router and security appliance with DPI capabilities, native VPN features, multiple WAN support, and so much more. Our development team has been working around the clock to bring you a solution that has higher performance and more features than anything else in the market, and all at an incredible price point. Today, we are going to unbox Route 10 for you, show you the physical appliance and what comes in the box, and then we will walk you through the initial setup and configuration of the device. When you first receive Route 10 and open the gift box, you will see the router. As we pull it out of its protective cover, you will notice the, its ultra-modern industrial design. It features a solid aluminum heatsink on the bottom. It has four Ethernet ports that support connections up to 2.5 gigabits per second, two of which are PoE Plus enabled. It also has two SFP ports, which are both capable of up to 10 gigabits per second. It's powered by an external power supply that is included in the box. You will note the chassis of the Route 10 actually has a security loop you can use to attach the power cable to help remove the possibility of any accidental unplugging events. Also in the box is the wall mount bracket and associated hardware kit. Now we will go through a couple of configuration options. First, for a brand new project, where there's no existing network infrastructure and you want to configure Route 10 so it can begin to interface with your internet service provider, go ahead and connect the power adapter to Route 10 and connect it to a power source. Then connect your ISP's connection to your preferred WAN port, whether that is an RJ45 on WAN 1, which by default is the first RJ45 port, or via SFP Plus module on the WAN 2 port, which defaults to the second SFP Plus port. There are several methods that you can use to get Route 10 online. We'll start with the mobile application because it is the most straightforward. Make sure your mobile device is connected to the internet, either via cellular or another Wi-Fi connection. Open up the Alta Networks app on your mobile device. Ensure that you are close enough to Route 10 to use Bluetooth, and wait for the Route 10 device to appear. Once it appears, go through the setup process, answering each question that corresponds to your specific ISP's settings. This process will automatically add the Route 10 device to your currently selected Alta site as well. Instead of using the mobile app, you can use a wired connection to set up your new Route 10. Connect your laptop or PC via Ethernet cable into any of the labeled LAN ports on Route 10. Once a link has been established, open any web browser and navigate to the IP address 192.168.1.1. If it indicates that the internet is already connected, you can skip the next step and go directly to manage.alta.inc to set up your device in your desired Alta Lab site. Once the page loads, select the appropriate WAN port. For this example, we will configure static. Enter the credentials provided to you by your ISP. Click Next. Route 10 supports WAN-side VLAN tagging should your ISP require it. For this example, our ISP does not require it. Our ISP also does not require the use of a specific MAC ID. Our ISP also auto-negotiates the link speed. Click Next. Your Route 10 will now go in and attempt to connect to your ISP. If this is successful, you will see a success message. If it is not, you will need to check your settings and try again. Once successfully connected to the internet, you can now add it to your site at manage.alta.inc or using our self-hosted or on-prem controller options. Once added to the site, you can configure your Route 10 further. These additional configurations will be covered later in this video. After you've added the device to your Alta site, it will take a couple of minutes to connect and update its firmware to the latest release. The third method is if you already have existing network infrastructure in place and you want to configure your Route 10 before using it to replace your existing router. Power up your Route 10 and take an Ethernet cord from your WAN port on your Route 10 into any available switch port on your existing network. It's important to remember that your existing network infrastructure cannot have a 192.168.1.x subnet. Currently, Route 10 cannot be configured in this manner and you'll need to either use a LAN with a different subnet or reconfigure your LAN to a different subnet. If you are using our self-hosted controller or on-prem controller, be sure to connect it to an available LAN port on your Route 10 to set up Route 10 in your management ecosystem for the first time. Once completely booted up and with the Ethernet cable plugged in between Route 10's WAN 1 or WAN 2 port and the switch, you will see Route 10 appear in your site at manage.alta.inc or on your local controller. From there, you can click Setup. Once added to the site, the Route 10 device will automatically update its firmware and reconnect. Once added to your site, open the Route 10 device card by clicking on the image next to the product name. The device card opens, showing you the available ports on Route 10. Pick the one you want to use to connect to your ISP. Set the mode to WAN. Then in the WAN dropdown, you can select WAN 1, WAN 2, or create a new WAN. I am going to select WAN 1 and then click the Edit button. A new window will appear. You can name the WAN connection, select the type, which you can see it currently supports DHCP, static, or PPPoE. I will choose static and then enter the IP, gateway, and DNS settings provided to me by my ISP. Then hit save. At this point, you will need to move Route 10 to the head end of your network so it can now begin to communicate with your ISP and you can continue to configure your Route 10. You can have two or more WAN configurations set up for failover and load balancing. Now that your Route 10 is set up on your site and communicating with your ISP, you can proceed to configure your LAN ports. This can be done by clicking into any of the available ports you want to assign to your LAN. Be sure to set your mode to standard. Make any other VLAN assignments, then hit save. If you'd like Route 10 to associate and serve up a subnet on multiple VLANs, return to the Route 10 device card that opens when you first click the Route 10 icon. Add or edit the VLAN numbers you want associated with the subnet. Add a note for the VLAN number, set the subnet IP range and size. If you want to reserve a certain number of IPs at the very beginning of your range, enter that number in the reserved IPs range. If you want a lease time or DNS server other than default, enter those values here. Finally, enable IGMP snooping if it's required, and then hit save. Your Route 10 now has a basic configuration and is ready to work in your network projects. If you want to make adjustments to the built-in firewall, navigate to the Settings tab and then the Firewall option. We will continue to roll out additional firmware updates in the coming weeks that will enable the native VPN features, our DPI engine for content filtering, and so on. For a full list of features that will be included with Route 10, please visit alta.inc/route10. We hope you are as excited about Route 10 as we are. If you'd like us to add features in Route 10 that you don't see us planning to deploy, please come and engage with us in our community at forum.alta.inc. Thanks for being Alta Labs fans.